The suburbs. They're both suburbs of...
Here's Palffy shooting one wide to the right side of Paxton Schaefer. And another souvenir with a minute 23 of power play time remaining to the Islanders.
Close call. Take a look at our Chrysler League leaderboard.
Goes too aggressively about trying to present Gordy in areas around and part of hockey that should be left alone. I think that Gordie Howe should be always in. But look out here. There we go. A little wrap around. You can see it coming as Palffy came out of the corner. And Paxton Schaefer watches Zigmund Palffy put one in behind. He's given up 3 goals now in the NHL. He's only played in, about 40 minutes, a little more than that. About 43 minutes of NHL time. He's given up 3 goals. A power play goal here for the Islanders. As a close call by the penalty killers of Boston. But the Islanders recover. And out of the corner, Zigmund Palffy after Robert Reichel spots him there. And then the quick hands of Palffy has made it 5-1.
Then the chance plays it back to the Islander blue line. Baskey played it off of the linesman. And here comes Palffy. Quick shot. He scores! Number 43 for Ziggy. 6-1 they are.
Schaefer just punched the crossbar. He was looking for help, didn't get it. It went off the goalpost and trickled in, but Palffy, his quickness, low, looking for it, into the open side, and he gets it. 5-1 goes to 6-1 on Zigmund Palffy's 43rd goal of the season. Low, quick shot off the post, and it's a counter.
Well, remember, if Ziggy or anybody else this afternoon, Smolinski's got two, gets a hat trick, Discover Card donates $500 to the local chapter of the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Somebody threw a hat. Wait a minute. That's only two.
Hey, come on. They're lowering the standards.
Right. We'll ask Mr. Matt here. He's with us, and we'll ask him. It takes three for a hat trick, right?
Yeah. He's got it. Yeah, it's mascot day here at the Nassau Coliseum. Several NHL mascots are on hand, and so is Mr. Met. Chelsea, take cover!
Brian Smolinski on the right, Robert Reichel on the left, and we're still calling them smoke and fire. And there's what's going on today. 2 goals and a plus 3, 4 assists and a plus 3, 2 goals and an assist for Zigmund Palffy.
We've got to email it and try and get a new name for the line as they keep climbing, keep on working towards making it to the playoffs.
So the Islanders doing what they have to do at home against an admittedly weak team. These were games, though, that gave the Islanders problems earlier in the year. Started thinking you had an opportunity to take something for granted. And then a Tampa Bay, for example, would come in. The Islanders would be flat. First time the Bruins came in here. Earlier this month, the Islanders were flat.
5-2. Boston beaten in that hockey game.
But the Islanders took charge right from the start. Smolinski centers. Palffy scores! That's the hat trick! Number 44 for Ziggy. 8-1 Islanders.
Don't leave him around the front of the net with a loose puck. Somebody's either going to have to make a tremendous save or it's going to bend the twine. And that's exactly what happened. Smolinski from behind. There's Palffy just pounded it into the right side of the net to the left of the goaltender, Paxton Schaefer. Palffy there, slam dunk.
And his third goal of the hockey game. We've got a period plus 11.5 seconds. Still the play, so Ziggy Palffy, hat trick time.
It's his third career hat trick. He had back-to-back hat tricks in early March of last year. And since the Islanders have a player with a hat trick, Discover Card donates $500 to the local chapter of the Make-A-Wish Foundation. And as there were only 11 and a half seconds to go in the period when Palffy scored, rather than take time to pick up all the hats, they're doing the smart thing, and they're going to call play now, send the teams to their respective rooms, and just tack the 11 and a half seconds on to the third period, or at the very least to the time right after the upcoming intermission. Islanders 8, Bruins 2, and it was as simple as that. The Islanders breaking to a four-goal lead in the first period. Zigmund Palffy would come up with a hat trick in the second period. Smolinski had two of those goals in the first, and really for the Islanders, an issue that was never in doubt, and you could almost sense it from the first shift, because they came out with a resolve that really backed up how necessary it was to get two more points this afternoon. Stan Fischler is standing by downstairs with our star of the game. Stan?
Well, he was singing on the bench, and he had plenty to sing about. A magnificent game for Ziggy Palffy. He's leading this team toward a playoff berth, and remember when you were singing in the third period? You were doing like this. Remember?
No, I don't remember singing.
Well, then you were dancing. I mean, whatever you were doing.
I tried to watch.
Well, did you have an itch? Did you have an itch? Is that...
A little bit. It's cold. My feet is cold.
Well, look, I've been away a little bit. Make believe I'm your cousin and tell me why the team's doing so well since I saw you last.
I think because we're playing great defensively, you know, and we stick together. I think 20 guys working hard, you know, and everything's going well for us. We shooting puck more than the net, and we have a lot of chances.
And Reichel?
I think it helps a lot right now, you know. We play better power play. We score goals, you know, and... if you have a scoring chance, you're going to score a goal. You know it's a goal.
And Ziggy told me before we went on that the language Czech, Slovak is the same, really. So do you guys talk in your native language when you're on the ice?
We talk just about a face-off, you know, where you're going to stand. But on the bench, we talk a little more, you know, what you're going to do if D is going down and we put a puck up, you know. And it's just, you know, sometimes, not all the time. You have to speak English because his smoke is over there.
The man scored a hat trick. We're going to take a look at the goal that made it number three for Ziggy Palffy, and we'll see if we can take you through it. Take me through it right there.
Oh, just to put it back behind the net and try to go to the front of the net, and puck is going after me, and just try to shot the net. It was a goal.
Well, you know, when you got that technique. What about Smolinski? How do you feel about him on the line?
I think he's great, you know. We fill it up, you know, our line, you know, and he's playing great defensively. He's all the time low and just playing great right now.
Smolinski speak English? How's he speaking?
Speak English great.
Now, the hockey club now obviously getting closer to the making the playoffs. When you talked to me earlier in today, I remember you said something, hey, maybe the Stanley Cup, remember?
It's really hard right now. You know, we have one point like from a playoff spot, you know, and there's another game is right now, Dallas, and we have to think about Dallas right now, you know, and it's coming like we have to win right now a couple games, and we see what happens, you know.
Well, you're on a roll, and he's the reason why the Islanders are on the roll. They're getting closer and closer. We'll have more of the post-game show right after this.